In this lesson, we will talk about the forces experienced by the charged particles. We know that when a charged particle having magnitude Q is placed in an electric field of E bar, then it experiences a force. The magnitude of force is Q times E, and the direction of force is in the direction of electric field. This we have studied in electrostatics. Now, in place of electric field, if the same charged particle is placed in a magnetic field, will it experience any force? It was observed that the force in magnetic field, let's write E the suffix for electric field and B suffix for magnetic field. If a charge is placed at rest in magnetic field, the force experienced by the charged particle is observed to be zero. Now, if the same charged particle is projected with certain velocity v, then it was observed that it experiences a force. That force is directly proportional to B, the magnetic field. Directly proportional to Q, the charge. If the magnitude of the charge is more, then the force experienced by the charged particle is also more. If the magnitude of magnetic field is more, then force experienced by the charged particle is also more. Now, it is directly proportional to the perpendicular component of the velocity of the projection. Now, when we combine these three, we can write F is directly proportional to QVB sine theta, or to remove the proportionality sign, we have to multiply it by a constant. Here the constant is 1, therefore, practically it was proved, therefore, F is equal to QVB sine theta is the force experienced by the charged particle in a magnetic field. Now, if I wanted to write in vector notation, VB sin theta can be written as V cross B. So this is the force experienced by the charged particle having the magnitude Q, which is projected V with the velocity V with some angle with the direction of the magnetic field, then F, the force experienced by that charged particle, is equal to QV cross B. Let us discuss some points regarding this. F is equal to QV cross B. These two results were observed by Lorentz. So that's why this is called Lorentz force. If you talk about this force, the force is perpendicular to both velocity direction and magnetic field direction, and it is perpendicular to both the two. So that's why V cross B. Now, previously we talked about when a charged particle is placed in a magnetic field. Is placed means its velocity is zero. Therefore, this equation is satisfied for that also. When V is equal to zero, it implies that the force acting on the charged particle, which is placed in magnetic field, is also zero. Now, what could be the other cases where FB is 0? So, as it is involving sin theta component, FB is equal to 0 when theta is equal to 0 or theta is equal to 180. What's the meaning of theta is equal to 0? Theta is equal to 0 means when you are projecting the charged particle in the direction of magnetic field, then it does not experience any force. Similarly, when the charged particle is projected just opposite to the direction of magnetic field, then also it does not experience any force. It moves in a straight line. What happens in all other cases? If the theta is not 0 or 180, then what happens? And when it can experience the maximum force, we know that QVB sin theta is the expression for force. This theta is pi by 2 radians or 90 degrees, then F becomes F maximum. That means when the charged particle is thrown in a perpendicular direction to the magnetic field, then it experiences more force. Now, let me demonstrate this Lorentz force. What Lorentz force says, suppose if a charged particle is thrown in a magnetic field, it experiences force, and that force is QVB sin theta, where Q is the charge of the charged particle, and V is the velocity with which it is thrown, and B is the magnetic field, and theta is the angle between the velocity vector and magnetic field vector. Now here, I have taken the magnetic field with the help of three strong circular magnets. And now here, I have taken a petri dish, and then I put some water, and in that water, sodium chloride is dropped. Now, when I allow the electricity to pass through this sodium chloride, it will be splitted into ions. Now, this sodium ion is under the magnetic field. It will be rotated in a circular path. Let us see that first. So, you can see now the rotation is clockwise. Now, if I change the polarity of the battery, it is in the opposite direction. So this indicates that the ion, sodium ion, is under the influence of magnetic field experiencing Lorentz force, which provides the centripetal force because of which it is moved in circular path.